It has been 10 years. 10 long years since I first discussed a bizarre being in Saintro 2, simply known as the Freezer. For those unfamiliar with this anomaly, the Freezer is a shadow-like figure that has a chance of appearing when a player has escaped the boundaries of the Zombie Uprising activity. Once seen, this entity will crash your game and potentially damage the physical disc. Since it was first discovered, the Freezer has grown quite a legacy behind its name, from player investigations, data mining, fan theories, to even references in other games. It seems the only thing we haven't been able to uncover in all these years is an official reason for the Freezer's existence. When Volition used to be confronted with the question, they'd always brush it off and allude to not knowing the truth.
They were asking about the Freezer yesterday, too. That is a reference that's gone over my head.
Is that the reference to the failed game, the Freezer?
Many fans believed we had never truly learned the reason for the Freezer's presence. However, some recently uncovered information may just be the final piece to lay this mystery to rest once and for all. Though, before we can dive into this new evidence, we have to quickly look over the history of the Freezer to have a complete understanding of how all these puzzle pieces come together. With that said, let's start at the beginning, one last time. Back in 2010, the Freezer was still a fairly unknown phenomenon, only having a small presence within online forums. I personally became aware of the Freezer from the Urban Legends section of the Old Time Splitters 4 fan website. Now, I've always been skeptical of these types of gaming superstitions, but what made the Freezer's mythos so intriguing was the fact you had to perform a glitch during Zombie Uprising to see it. See, when attempting to leave the play area of the activity, it will cause you to immediately fail. However, the glitch provided in the post claimed to allow the player to fully explore the city, so the inner glitch hunter in me knew I had to give it a shot. First, you need to start the Zombie Uprising activity with the cheats Never Die, Low Gravity, and Super Explosions. Then, you just need to play like normal until a zombie drops a grenade. Stand roughly in this area and use the grenade to blast yourself onto this ledge. Finally, throw one last grenade in this corner and jump to get propelled above and out of the old Stillwater Underground. You will fall into the abyss before respawning on the barren streets of the city. With all that, you'll have successfully escaped the activity. The post goes on to claim that once a player is free, some mysterious things are bound to occur. Still not convinced, I was content with simply wandering the streets, though my curiosity quickly turned to fear when specific events came to fruition. It states that when random objects begin moving on their own, lights become brighter than usual, and zombies occasionally spawn around the player, it's only a matter of time before the Freezer makes its presence. Everything listed was quickly happening before suddenly, I was face to face with the shadow figure. Within seconds, the game froze before I could even react. Taken aback by this, I restarted my console, and just as the post warned, my copy of Saintro 2 no longer functioned. This was all just so strange, I couldn't help but wonder why something so hazardous could exist within a video game. Was it an Easter egg? A deterrent to keep players from escaping the activity? An unknown glitch? With so many questions, it was frustrating that such little information could be found online. It wouldn't be until 2014 that I'd make my first video on the Freezer and ignite a community-wide investigation. For the next year and a half, numerous clues would be uncovered on the workings of the Freezer, and countless theories would arise attempting to explain its appearance. One such theory is that the Freezer is in fact a glitched zombie. It was discovered that even after glitching out the activity, the NPC survivors you start with could still take on the undead. Each time a survivor kills a zombie, there's a chance a new one will spawn in the radius of the player. Therefore, it was believed the Freezer was a zombie that would spawn near the player when they just happened to be near a wall or geometry. It spawns inside, only revealing its shadow before crashing the game. What helps support this claim is that even the player can take on a shadow-like form whenever you glitch inside an area you're never meant to access. The only problem with this theory is that the Freezer's silhouette doesn't resemble any of the zombie models. Plus, there have been no documented Freezer sightings where the zombie counter has changed just before crashing. One other prominent theory is that the Freezer is a distant ped. For those who don't know, a distant ped is a low-poly effect that loads just outside the player's field of vision to give the illusion that there's more NPCs roaming the city. There have even been rare occasions where a distant ped will spawn closer than usual to the player. Though none of these cases resulted in the game crashing, and no regular distant ped has been spotted when playing the activity. Okay, so this video would take all day if I delve into every single theory out there, so let's move past that and focus on concrete discoveries. The two earliest objectives of the investigation was to narrow down where the Freezer appears and if it varies between ports of the game. This led to the community discovering early on that the Xbox 360 was the only console which the Freezer could be found. On the PlayStation 3, crashes have happened during the activity, but without any sightings of the Freezer. As for the PC, it was a bit more complicated considering how unstable that build is, but it was concluded that the Freezer couldn't be found on there either. Even the digital version of Saints Row 2 on the 360 has no recorded sightings. Therefore, we are able to determine from the inconsistencies between ports that the freezer couldn't be an Easter egg or a built-in deterrent from Volition. As time went on, new sightings revealed a pattern for where the freezer would most commonly spawn. These include the exterior of the airport, the high-end retail district, and occasionally the downtown district. Though the most common location to encounter the freezer was the underpass in the red light district. What makes this even more peculiar is that it's the only location close enough to the Stillwater Undergrounds that the activity's music can still be heard. The next big discovery wouldn't come until August of 2014 when it was uncovered that the freezer could appear in the multiplayer. The earliest documented case comes from Flippy and I playing on the map Stillwater Science while searching for glitches. Flippy just happened to get stuck while performing the flashbang glitch, causing his game to crash, ending the session. However, just before losing connection, the freezer briefly appeared on my screen. Keep in mind that I've crashed and lost connection in the multiplayer countless times, but I've never once seen the freezer in any other session. What made things even more baffling is that Stillwater Science is the only multiplayer map to have this random prompt to start Zombie Uprising. Normally, you're only able to start Zombie Uprising in the campaign from either your crib's television or arcade machine scattered around the map. Though there are some random locations which the prompt will appear. Just to mention a few, the prompt can be found next to this railing in the mall, this stand in the airport, and this pretzel machine in the courthouse. Though oddly enough, the same prompt in the Stillwater Science multiplayer map doesn't appear in the single player. It's quite bewildering to say the least, but this confirms the freezer is intertwined with the activity in one way or another. Soon after that, we learned the freezer could rarely spawn without the player crashing. In some of my old footage, some eagle-eyed viewers were able to spot key moments where the freezer would flash on the screen. It would only be there for 2-3 frames, and only when my character was passing through geometry in either the activity or Stillwater Science. How this ties into everything isn't exactly clear. When I would later attempt to recapture this phenomenon, it simply would never happen. For the next couple years, not much new information would be uncovered until a potential breakthrough in June of 2017. I was given a very unique copy of Saints Row 2, which according to the previous owner was damaged by the freezer, but was still able to start up and function. Well, function is a bit of a stretch. The game will start after an absurdly long load time, but it all goes downhill from there. Cutscenes are completely broken, the prison and red light district are the only map chunks that load, vehicles, NPCs, and a majority of the clothing items won't spawn, and lastly, building geometry will randomly be missing its hit detection. If all that wasn't bad enough, the disc is prone to crashes and each one has the potential to brick your Xbox. I mean, it at least bricked mine, but that may have been a coincidence? Anyway, later when attempting to stream the broken disc on a new Xbox, I was astonished to see the game was running near perfectly.
Well, what the... Shoot. And the disc is actually working for some reason.
That's weird.
See, it just so happens that the disc performance depends on the type of Xbox being used to play it. If you're looking to play the disc with all its issues, you need to be on either the old Jaspers or some of the early versions of the Xbox Slim. From this information, we've been able to theorize that the freezer isn't just bound to the Xbox, but its appearance is dependent on the hardware used to find it. This would help explain why some players could never find the freezer, especially with how many players moved on from the older Xboxes due to the notorious Red Ring of Death. Back to the broken disc, I was able to observe something quite fascinating my first time playing. Even though NPCs couldn't spawn, disimpeds could still be seen in specific areas. When I would approach them, the game would crash just as the disimped would fade away. Taking a closer look, doesn't this look familiar? Kinda like the freezer, right? This would feed into the old theory that the freezer was simply a glitched disimped all along. This would also remain the most acknowledged theory for the freezer for the next 6 years. After a decade of speculation and research, it seemed the freezer would remain one of those long-lost gaming mysteries to never truly be uncovered. Well, that would be the case if it wasn't for one last recent discovery. This takes us to the unlikely source Reddit, where we find the user known as Synopser. If the name sounds familiar, Synopser claimed the work at Volition back in 2008 and provided proof by revealing 3 unknown Easter eggs in Saints Row 2. So safe to say, he's the real deal. Anyway, on the True Gaming subreddit, Synopser left this intriguing comment under a discussion about secret video game levels. Quote, when I was working on Saints Row 2 many years ago, one of the developers had added a series of zombie-themed secret levels that were accessed by some pretty random events. Squat 3 times in the found at X headquarters, etc. On one fateful day, about a month before Gold, it was found by testers on accident. Of course, the developer had not informed any of the leads that this was going into the game, so you can imagine the hassle it created. When it was discovered and all the ways to enter the levels were handed over to test, the game broke. We had only allocated so much save data for missions, and the extra 4-3 levels caused a memory overwrite, totally boning your save data. Could have been a crash too. At a glance, this may just seem like a fascinating case of a dev trying to hide unique secrets in their game. This wouldn't even be the first time it's happened in the series. But when you look a bit closer, certain pieces start falling into place. You have hidden levels that tie directly into the zombie uprising activity. They were found late into development, and a further investigation revealed they completely wrecked the game. The content had to be removed within the same month of going gold, and now there just happens to be a shadow figure in the full release that crashes your game when escaping said activity. So if I had to guess, the freezer has all along been an unforeseen glitch birthed by developers who had to quickly remove secret zombie uprising levels. This could also explain the random zombie uprising prompts found around the open world, and even the freezer sightings on the one multiplayer map that has an uprising prompt as well. Now, this still doesn't explain the freezer's physical form or why only specific versions of the Xbox 360 are affected, but compared to other theories, it does make the most sense. But okay, in case you still feel iffy about all this, I did reach out to some Volition devs to finally get a direct response. This is the explanation I was given. We used basement worlds for everything you couldn't get to normally, missions, cutscenes, and stores. Some of those have to be manually turned off. From the top of my tester head, I could see those getting tossed in the memory from proximity after you've fallen for a bit and never told to unload. So essentially, they believe the player escaping the zombie uprising activity by falling under the map causes basement worlds to improperly load in, and for old Stillwater to remain loaded. This makes it only a matter of time before these loaded interiors conflict with the surrounding map chunks the player is exploring. Perhaps this improperly loaded memory is too much for the older Xbox hardware to process, resulting in the game crashing. I mean, map chunks have always been a problem for older Xboxes, even back in Saints Row 1. So it isn't far-fetched to believe this is the reason only Xboxes encounter this issue. This would even explain how zombies can still be killed by survivors without the player being anywhere near Old Stillwater, since the location hasn't properly unloaded from memory. It's also quite curious how many documented freezer sightings occur near a basement world or a loaded interior. Take the Red Light District underpass. Perhaps being just below the surface of the map within proximity of the Old Stillwater undergrounds and bordering between two map chunks overloads the game, causing it to crash. Now, as for the freezer's physical appearance, I was told it could potentially be a rendering error which causes a projection of the player's shadow to appear wherever the camera happens to be facing when the game freezes. We already knew that shadows could get finicky when the players glitched outside normal bounds, so it could very well be the case that the loaded basement worlds also disrupt the placement of the player's shadow as things overload. This could also explain why the freezer occasionally spawned when the player would break through a boundary of an interior. And when you consider that the zombie uprising activity forces the player to use similar looking biker models, it makes sense that the freezer's silhouette always looks the same per sighting. Now, of course, this theory wouldn't exactly explain the freezer's appearance in the multiplayer, but in any case, there's more than enough evidence to conclude that the freezer is nothing more than an unforeseen glitch which only affects older Xbox hardware. Personally, I like to believe that a blend of Synopsis story combined with the remarks of the other Volition devs paints a full enough picture. But things like the physical disc being damaged is information we may never truly know. Though after 10 years, I can confidently feel that this mystery has come to an end. Now, I would have loved for the freezer to be an intentional Easter egg by Volition, not considering the extensive lawsuits that would have come from gamers' disc breaking, but it's clear the freezer is simply a hardware-dependent bug.
I guess we debunked the myth, guys. This is what the freezer is, it's just a fucking shadow.
Plus, with the 360 becoming more scarce, there will come a day that the freezer will never be seen again. But the one thing I love about Saints Row is that this series is full of mysteries. There's still a merman out there that has to be stopped. We still don't know how to customize aircrafts in the third, even though there's evidence it's possible. Who the hell is this? What the hell is that? If you count Agents of Mayhem, there's dozens of Easter eggs that haven't been uncovered. There's a hidden message in the reboot that no one has bothered to uncode. I've even heard of sightings of a chupacabra. Volition may be gone and the future of the franchise is uncertain, but at least we can all still come together and uncover new things about the series we all love.
Just waiting right here. There it is, see? It was right there.
What the f***?
In the deep of the night, in the game they say, there's a shadow lurking, it's the freezer's way. Creeping through the streets with a chilling stride. Whispering in your ear, making you hide. In Saints Row 2. Where the chaos reigns, a frozen entity. Causing fear and pain's a phantom in the dark. Seeking to control. Leaving players shivering right down to their soul. Oh, the freezer's haunting. Beware. freeze your dreams in the video game where nothing's as it seems.
And then the eagle comes down for the kill, sweeping the baby giraffe off of its feet and devouring it. Om nom nom nom.
Kev, eagles don't eat baby giraffes.
What? They do. They eat babies. I've seen it with my own two spectacles.
Oh god. Kev has discovered what a dictionary is, everybody.
Well, if Kevin is saying that the eagles can eat the baby giraffes, then I say my army of boars can fuck up that rhino.
How does that make any sense?
What are rhino gonna do when 20 fucking boars are coming at it? Absolutely nothing, dumbass.
Jesus, I feel like a special needs kid playing this game.
Well, Kevin is special.
And I have lots of needs, wow.
Everyone in favor of getting Kevin castrated, say I.
Hey!
He's kidding, Kevin.
I wish he was, Nina. I really do.
Poker. Blackjack. Hell, I'll even take Go Fish. All things we could be playing instead of whatever retard game he recommended.
He is a retard.
Well, you're all water buffalo and I'm the lioness. About to pounce all over that ass. I win.
Oh, I'm the devil disguised as a snake. One bite. I win.
Giant-ass African elephant steps on you. I win and save the world from sin, bitch.
Oh, what the fuck?
Hey, whatever happened to that stalker?
Oh, me and Johnny beat the crap out of him and stuffed him in a freezer.
Did we get rid of that thing?
Yeah, we put him in the room. Oh, damn it. We stuffed him in Kevin's kitchen freezer.
A oh, that's guy great. In my things. Can't wait to fucking eat some waffles with some fucking frozen man meat, you fucking assholes.
I'll go fucking.
Sorry, Johnny.
I have got to stop doing shit for this woman. I am going to drive myself insane. What the fuck?
Hey, boss!
Kevin! Oh, fuck me, dude! Don't do that shit!
Whoa, sorry, boss. I just wanted to let you know that I Oh my god.
Shit, you see that too? What the fuck are we even gonna do against
it's
that
Casper,
thing?
It's Casper the Friendly Ghost! I love you, Casper! Ah!
Yeah, I just wanted to say, you guys fucking suck.
What?
I didn't even
What the hell
anything.
Are you talking about?
Yeah, you and that big booty Latina beat the crap out of me and left me to die in a freezer.
You killed Casper! How could you do such a thing?
Kevin, Casper is not real.
Ooh, Kevin, Casper isn't real. Next you're gonna tell me the Cookie Monster doesn't actually eat pussy!
What the hell kind of point have you been watching, man? Did we gotta take away your phone again?
The fun kind.
Look, I'm just here to let you know. You guys are bad people. Awful people, even. I was just trying to admire the beauty of a woman. And you killed me for it.
Yeah, I don't know about that one, Chief.
Yeah,
it's just kind of weird.
Usually look at men.
Now my wife's a widow, and my kids are fatherless. They go to a Catholic school, man. Do you know how expensive that shit is?
I don't know. Expensive!
Yeah, expensive. Now my kids are gonna have to go to public school, where one will probably be bullied for having a dead dad. I hope you can live with that, knowing you tore a family apart today.
Yeah, sure, man. I feel fucking awful.
Yeah. I bet you do.
So he's not Casper?
He's not Casper, Kevin! Oh! Casper!